You're in.
All right, so we are very excited this evening to have Dr. Koso with us, who, as you know, is our interim president of the University of Louisville, to talk to us about strategic development at the university. And I will also say whatever else you would like to talk to us about higher education and your thoughts on administration and how things work, because that is what this class is all about. And please feel free to ask questions and chime in.
Thank you so much.
So without further ado, and here's a clicker for you.
Clicker and everything. Yeah. Well, hello, how are you all? And I hope our online students are able to see as well. Good evening to all of you. Don't let the tie and jacket fool you. I want to make this a little bit informal, so please feel free to stop me with questions. This can be as interactive as you wish. It's not a lecture, per se, but I hope an opportunity to get some conversation going. So I've been working at the University of Louisville since 1994. I came here when I was 32 years old, and I was at the medical school, and I'm a teacher, and that's why I came to the university. So from 1994 until about 2 years ago, I taught, and I had radiology residents and medical students and people who were learning about radiology, which is my specialty. So I love to teach, and I was really excited when I was given an opportunity to come tonight and talk to you, because as you might imagine, this year I haven't had a lot of chance to do that. I've been a little bit busy with some other things, and so it's exciting to see students again, instead of lawyers and accountants and reporters from the Courier Journal and all those folks who've been really fun here today. So anyway, thank you all for being here and for inviting me. So I like very much the sounds of this class when I heard about it. I'm thrilled that there are people who are interested in going into administration in higher education, because it's badly needed. There are not enough good administrators in universities, and every time we find someone who is well-educated and knowledgeable and good with people, we try to hire them as fast as we can. A lot of people don't like administrative roles. They don't. They'd rather do other things. They'd rather teach or do research, or in the case of health sciences campus, patients. And so there are some people who are cut out to help make the whole thing work, and there are others who aren't. And so I'm thrilled that you all have that interest, because it's great work. I spent most of my career taking care of patients and teaching residents and medical students about that. I obviously love that. But what I'm doing now is equally interesting, and I'm very blessed that I had two things in my life. It's almost like a second career. I had a chance to do two things that I really love, and the administrative work is really engaging. It's challenging. It's different every day. You don't get bored. You have to draw upon all kinds of skills that you've learned along the way, both in school and in life, to be able to make fair decisions. Way to make a living. So tonight, I'm just going to spend some time talking a little bit about strategy, because a strategy for what you're doing is really kind of at the heart of everything. If you don't have a good strategy, heaven knows where you'll end up. We'll just wander aimlessly. That's the real reason for everything we do. And so how you develop that strategy is really, really important. And how you operate a clicker is really important. Because this one doesn't work. Unless, it's turned off. There's a key. All right, how about that? All right, so when I say setting the stage, you go right to the basics and say, okay, why is this institution here? I don't mean just UofL, but wherever you're working. And what is the mission of the organization that employed you, or where you might not have profit? And you really have to understand that. And so one of the things that's nice about the University of Louisville, and why so many people stay and work here for years and years, is we've got a great mission, and people are fired up about it. And we are teaching students. We're taking care of incredibly sick patients. We're doing research. We're engaging with our community. We're making sure that diversity is a part of all of those missions, so it's not really a standalone, but it's something that's woven into all of those. And that combination of things exciting. It causes people to want to come here to go to school and want to stay here afterwards and work. These are either a faculty member, an administrator, or a staff person. So you have to know what the mission is. And this next part, though, is, you know, as an administrator, you'll find that this is a really interesting and complicated problem. That is, who has determined the mission, right? And there are a lot of possibilities, okay? So it could be developed through a campus process, which is probably the best way to do it. So we're going to talk a little bit tonight about the 2020 plan and the 21st century initiatives that have been in place for a long time ago. Well, both of those things were put in place as a result of a really intense, long, campus-wide project. So in those days, the provost was Shirley Willinghans, and she engaged people far and wide across both UofL campuses to come together and really spend a lot of time thinking about what it is that the institution was going to do and what the mission was going to be. And so we'll talk a little later tonight about the concept of shared governance. This is a nice example of shared governance. And we have as many people as possible weighing in so that the mission is really representative of the people who make up the institution. So that's one place a mission could originate. But there's other possibilities. So, you know, everybody has a boss, and my boss is the Board of Trustees. And the Board of Trustees, 13 people, 10 of them are appointed by the governor. The other three are in their positions because they represent a group on campus. So there's a student, there's a staff person, there's a faculty person. So 13 in total. In some institutions, the Board of Trustees plays a very serious role in setting the mission for the institution, for better or for worse. And so that is one of the factors. Now here, that's not the case. And the reason being is this board is new, and there was an existing mission in place, and they have not chosen to alter it. And so really that's not something that they have, at least in the year that they've been in their positions, weighed in on or tried to make any significant change in the direction of the institution. But it could happen. You all could end up working someplace in a day where a board plays a very heavy-handed role in setting the mission of the institution. Donors, I guarantee you, donors will try to influence the mission. The more money they give, the harder they'll try. So if somebody's going to give you $1 million or $10 million, they're going to have an opinion. And you know, it's an art to be gracious about accepting the gift and making sure that you honor the wishes of the donor, but only to an extent. I mean, you can't allow somebody's personal agenda to do something that harms the whole institution. So if somebody tries to give you $1 million and there are strings attached, it would be harmful to UofL. You know, as painful as it is, I'm going to give it back. Say, you know, we can't do that. Now, if you know, if they want to give me $1 million and create a chair for teaching people to be wonderful oboe players, that's great. Okay, so if they've got a mission that adds to, you know, our educational content or programming we offer, that kind of thing is wonderful. But you have to be aware that donors sometimes can have very very serious agendas associated with money that they donate. The public and the media, you know, they're not the same, but there's a lot of overlap between those two concepts. I guarantee you, always has an interest in what is going on and what the mission is, and they will always have something to say about it. So, you know, it doesn't seem to matter what we do, there'll be a story about it. And some people will think it's great, and some people will be angry and send nasty notes, and it's just, it's a backdrop of work that we do, particularly here in a state or a public institution like UofL. So you have to be aware of it. But again, that's not what really should be setting the agenda. It's just sort of background information that's important to be aware of. And then the strong personalities, we kind of touched on this with donors, but it's not limited to that. I mean, certainly strong personalities you see among faculty members and among administrators, and you know, some people really, you know, want to get involved and try to exert personal influence. So I guess the reason I give you this list is one of the jobs in administration is to learn how to balance input. Okay, so I think that's probably, you know, if you remember something tonight and think about this. You're going to receive input from so many different sources. And understanding how to put it all together and then figure out how it fits appropriately and not let any of the pieces have too much weight is an art. And it takes practice and experience to develop an ability to do that. But it's essential because, you know, you're going to get input from a lot of different places, more than you can ever imagine, about decisions that are being made. So once you start thinking about the agenda and you get all this input from different places and you try to put it down in a way that's balanced, you have to ask yourself, okay, well, is this a starting point? Are we starting fresh? Or was there a pre-existing mission? And it's quite different. So if you start with a blank piece of paper, that's one thing. But if there was a pre-existing mission, you need to pull it out and read it and understand what it says and how the realities of today fit with what's already there. Because the question is, you know, is it still relevant? And again, in a minute we're going to talk about the 2020 plan. You know, there's a pre-existing strategy or mission statement. You know, how long ago was it written? Is it still relevant? What has happened at the institution and in the city and in the state and with the student population? What's taken place since this agenda was written? Helps you determine whether it's still relevant. If it's been in place for a long time, have any of the goals been achieved? You know, did it work? And if so, why? And if not, why not? So, you know, those are all things that really have to be thought through if you're starting to develop a strategy. So in the case of U of L, there is pre-existing strategy document, as we've indicated. What this is, there's two documents, the 2020 plan and the 21st century initiative. So the 2020 plan really is the strategic plan, all right? And that's been around for quite a while. It was written like in 08, okay? So it's been around for a long time. And that is the strategic plan that is still in place for the University of Louisville. The 21st Century Initiative was not a new strategic plan. It was written 3 or 4 years later. What it was designed to do is provide some tactics and some guidance as to how to achieve some of the goals that were written in the 2020 plan. So I think when, you know, the 21st Century Plan was being developed, it was recognized that not everything was working so well. 2020 plan, and you know, what is it that we need to do to tweak the 2020 plan? What is it going to take for us to, you know, make better progress on the goals of the 2020 plan? And so what were they? So if you think about it, the 2020 plan sort of referred to five pillars or five areas of focus that were important in the eyes of the people who developed that plan. And so it won't surprise you that education was the first one on the list because we're at our university and so we're here to teach. But then right behind it, you know, research and creativity and scholarly activity, that was the second pillar. Followed closely by diversity, opportunity, and social justice, then community engagement, and then creative and responsible stewardship. And there we're talking about taking care of the resources of the university. They could be human resources, they could be financial assets, they could be the dollars that the donors have given, they could be our buildings. Are we taking care of our resources? Are we being good stewards of the university and its assets? And these really are in no particular order other than the fact that education is listed first, but they're all important. It's hard to say, you know, which one is really more important than the other because they're all critical. And so as we have started today to look back on this document, say it has 2017, this document is approaching 10 years in age, you know, is this document still relevant? So the questions I asked on the last slide, right? So we know how old it is it still relevant? You know, if so, why? If not, why not? Have these goals been achieved? And what kinds of changes would we need to make? And so one of the things that I have been doing is having a series of campus open forums where we sort of begun going around and talking to the staff and the faculty about the 2020 plan and going through each one of these pillars and trying to get input, saying, you know, is this still valid? And how, if it's still valid, do we need to modify it and how? And what we're starting to hear is that, you know, these five pillars are kind of hard to improve upon as general goals. If you think about it, I mean, that's really who we are, right? I mean, this is a very good description of what University of Louisville does. The devil's in the details. I mean, the real question is, okay, how do we refine these in such a way that they really fit the students who are here today and the faculty and staff who were fortunate enough to afford the resources that we have. And so that's the trick. So I think what we're going to be seeing over the course of the next couple of years is not a wholesale replacement of this 2020 plan, but maybe going in and redefining each of the five in terms of, you know, what exactly are the techniques that we're going to use to improve our education and to promote diversity and to promote community engagement and to do more research and have more responsible stewardship of our resources. How are we going to do that? So, you know, it's easy to set goals, but it's another thing to reach them, right? And so, you know, you can set anything as a goal, but it has to be realistic.